Very good morning, organizer, and very good morning, participant. Is my voice audible? Okay, let me start the today's session. As planned for this FDP, today's session is dealing about kind of algorithms that are very successfully solving many kinds of engineering optimization problem. And those algorithms may collectively called by the name evolutionary computation techniques in terms of that principle, or swarm intelligent techniques in terms of their principle, that is inherent principle followed in it. Or in general, what one can say is it is bio-inspired algorithms. So participant, the first 3 days of class dealt with a kind of task called pattern recognition. Fourth day of the class dealt with a task called decision making. And this day, we are going to dealt with a task called optimization, and how that optimization task can be solved using bio-inspired algorithms. So let me go into the topic. Let me discuss few optimization in our life. Look at this example. Assume that you are walking in a road. At one point of time, your road branches into 5 sub-branches. You want to reach the destination, and at this point of time, what do you think about? So in general, you think about to reach the destination with minimum distance. Likewise, look at this picture. So there are two scholars for whom some jobs, you assume that they entered into some kind of interviews, and they have got some jobs from some different companies. For this, for example, say for example 3 companies. So what is the objective of these two person before joining into a company? That is, while choosing the company among the 3 companies available. So the objective of these two person is maximum salary. Look at the sentence: minimum distance and maximum salary. So from these two words, now I can define what is optimization. Optimization is one action taken by an individual or a group of individual so that his expectation is fulfilled. Expectation is in the sense objective. With respect to distance, it should be minimum. With respect to salary, it should be maximum. Likewise, so we are taking some effort or some initiation to seek desired perfection in our objective. Next, come to the second part, and one more example to dealt with optimization. Look at the picture. So what is these persons are discussing with the guys in the desk? Might be they are discussing with the rate of 4-wheelers, or they are in a mindset to purchase a 4-wheeler. So what might be the criteria, or what might be the mindset they have before going into buy a vehicle? So they have many criteria: good model, good color, good comfortness, good interiors, luxuriousness, and mileage. So there are many points, and cost. So there are many points are there in their mind, and they have to choose one criteria. They have to choose according to their objective phenomena. So in this situation, so what might be their optimization goal? So they need to go for choosing a vehicle mileage. Even though mileage is treated as a single parameter, it is treated as the vehicle should run maximum kilometer with minimum fuel consumption. So this is the way the optimization is defined for this particular scenario. So when you compare with the previous scenario with this scenario, in the previous scenario, the objective is one. Normally, you don't have only one objective. You have more than one objective, that is two or more like that. So this case, you have two objectives. One is maximum objective, another one is minimum objective. Likewise, look at this picture. Here, the person is going to buy something through online. So when you are going for buying any product, so what is the thing that you have in your mind? So here also, you have to think about to buy any product. It may be anything. You should look for maximum quality as well as minimum amount. So you always say a word like cheap and best. Cheap in terms of amount, that should be minimum. Best in terms of quality, that should be maximum. So in all these three slides, what do you infer? That is, optimization is there in our regular day-to-day life. Likewise, and I start yesterday class, I said about decision making. Decision making is to choose an alternative based on your willingness. Here, based on your objective. So you need to seek some perfection in your objective. So this is the way of optimization. So you don't confuse with that one and this one. Here, clear-cut objective is given and you have to fulfill the objective either in terms of producing the maximum value or in terms of producing the minimum value. But there, what kind of situation is given? The situation given to you is a fuzzy situation. That is vague situation. That is uncertain situation. In that situation, you have to take a decision. Normally, you can take a decision, but in the midst of some complex environment, how we are going to take an effective decision or how a system is going to take an effective system, effective decision in par with the human being. That's what the objective of yesterday's session. And that's what we are using. That's what you have to use fuzzy logic to develop such kind of expert system. But here, our objective is given some objective statement. Your task is to develop some algorithms or some procedure so that the objective is fulfilled. So the input for such kind of problem is not a data, even some data-based optimization also available, but the foremost idea here is some kind of objective function that should be mathematically stated. So first few slides discussed about the optimization in our day-to-day life. You have a single objective and you have more than one objective and it should be clearly stated with respect to parameters. So what are the two parameters here? One is quality parameter, another one is amount parameter. So with respect to quality parameter, the objective should be maximum. That is, one expectation is always go for best quality. And with respect to amount, always you seek to get a product with minimum amount only. So that's the scenario in our regular life of conducting the task of optimization. Now, let me discuss a few of the optimization in engineering. So look at the slide, automotive design, engineering design, robotics. You read the terms in automated design. You have to optimize the composite materials and aerodynamic shapes for designing a race car. In engineering design, you need to optimize the structure and the operational design of buildings, factories, and machines, and so on. With respect to robotics, you need to design the components of each and every robot so that the robot should be a compact in size. So in engineering also, you can face many problems that dealt with the idea of optimization. Look at evolvable hardware, optimization of the electronic circuit, telecommunication routing, that is optimal placement of the routing of the cell, that is components while you are making the data routing, computer gaming. So these slides are not enough to say the optimization in engineering domain. So optimization is not only in engineering domain, but also in many business analytics, medicine, in many places, optimization is there. So I have listed only few like cryptography, computer-aided molecular and design, and gene expression profiling. Participants, I wish to say that optimization is there in many of the research tasks, and the only thing you need to decide what kind of task is this and how it can be defined as a optimization task. So that's the idea for to give that idea only. These slides I have provided. So whenever you want to think about to solve an optimization problem, it should be mathematically stated in this form. Sorry, the equation is not visible, I think. Yes, in this form, it should be given. That is, it should be substituted with the word min or max, like this, with f, with respect to f of some set of variables. Like this, it should be given. Yes, I will take. So here, what is there is, the one which is in the left-hand side of the equal operator is the objective function f. That should be preceded by a word either max or min. So it is called as performance criterion or something you want to measure it quantitatively so that your objective is fulfilled, or simply speaking, it is called by the name objective or fitness function. And what about the one that is in the right-hand side of the operator? They are nothing but variables that decides the performance of capital F. The small f of x1, x2, x3, xn, that is x1 is a variable that decides the performance of capital F. So they are called by the name decision variable or solution variable. And you have to think that they might be, and there should be an independent parameter and adjustable parameter. So that is the idea here. So let me explain this with respect to one more real-time example. Sorry, it has some animation, so it is taking some time. So let me take an example, like preparation of coffee. Do you think that preparation of coffee is an example for optimization? So someone says that maybe no, but someone says that yes, if you clearly look into the problem. So to my view, the coffee preparation is an optimization problem. In what way I can define the coffee preparation as an optimization problem is, I will ask some n number of persons to prepare coffee. So now n number of persons are coming, say for example, n equal to some 10. That means 10 persons are coming to me to prepare coffee. I am offering them some amount of coffee powder, some amount of milk, and some amount of sugar to them. Now each one of the person is preparing their coffee on their own. Finally, what I will do is I will taste everyone's coffee and I will declare on coffee as the best coffee. So if that is the situation, or if I frame the problem of preparation of coffee as such, then I can say that my problem is an optimization problem. Participant, please think over it again. Whenever you want to proceed with a problem as an optimization problem, you should always have n number of alternatives. Look at the example of the first case in the real life example I have given. A person is walking along the road. At one point, he is facing five different paths. Look at the remember the second picture. Those two scholars are given with three jobs. Look at, remember the one who is going to buy a four-wheeler. He will be provided with many models, many versions, many types, many categories, many colors. Likewise, n alternatives have been provided. So each alternative will have its own facility or its own property. And it is the one to decide which one suits his requirement. So, or which one is treated as the best for that person or best for that particular occasion. So that's the idea here. So when I want to make this problem, that is preparation of coffee, as an optimization problem, then what I need to do, I need to create three ingredients, milk, sugar, and coffee powder, and I have to define each one as a variable. Then what is the thing that I am expecting? My taste, that is the taste of the coffee, should be maximum. So what I can do is, maximum of tea, that is, here tea is not with respect to tea, it is coffee taste. Maximum taste of the coffee will come out with respect to the correct proportion or correct mixing of milk, sugar and coffee. So what are the variables here? M, S and C are all variables which are treated as M is milk, S is sugar and C is coffee. If these three variables are clubbed together to create a to give a taste for a coffee, and that taste should be a maximum one. So that is the idea with respect to creating any problem into a mathematical statement. So before this formula, what I said, just a statement as preparation of coffee. So one, you want to think about this preparation of coffee problem as an optimization problem. The next step you should think about, in what way I can define this simple problem or simple natural problem as an optimization problem. For defining this problem as an optimization problem, you have to define it in a mathematical way. So this is the simple procedure of defining the problem in a mathematical way. How this mathematical should be there? It should have two things in the left hand side as well as the right hand side of the equal operator. In the left hand side, you should have a function T or F, which should be preceded by a word minimum or maximum. As well as in the right hand side, you should have n number of variables, and those variables are nothing but a solution variable which collectively gives the variable values. So that is the way in which you are going to do for solving any optimization problem. So participants, are you hearing me? Yes. So can I proceed further? Because someone is saying that my voice is not visible and audio is disconnecting. Yes. Now I am proceeding with that. So maximum T is equal to M plus S plus C. So provided, you should be provided with some constraint. So what are those constraints? Milk should be 25 ml to 100 ml. Sugar should be 1 by 4 teaspoon to 1 teaspoon. And coffee powder be 1 by 4. So what is the thing? Given this proportion, an individual is asked to prepare a coffee, and the individual has to take the proportion of milk within this range, proportion of sugar within this range, and proportion of coffee powder within the range. Someone may take 25 ml and some add water to it. Someone may take 100 ml and someone take 1 by 4 teaspoon, or someone may take 1 by 2 teaspoon of sugar. Someone may take 1 by 4 teaspoon of coffee powder, like that. So everyone is having their own value for preparing the coffee, but ultimately which gives the good taste of the coffee will be the final solution to this problem. So what is the solution to this problem? If I declare 1% coffee as the tastier coffee, then I'll ask that person how much milk you added. He may say that I added some 75 ml of milk. How much sugar you added? I added 1 by 2 teaspoon of sugar. How much coffee powder you added? I added 1 by 4 teaspoon of coffee powder. So that is the right proportion for preparing a coffee which gives maximum taste. Likewise, I have to conclude the problem with respect to giving solution to the problem. So what is the solution to the problem? Obtaining the value for M and S and C from the given range so that my T variable is satisfied with the maximum, that is maximum taste is obtained. I hope you follow this example. Next, what are the algorithm that we are going to see here is four kinds of algorithm we are going to see. Genetic algorithm, particle swarm optimization, artificial bee colony algorithm and ant colony algorithm. So in the afternoon session, I will give you a demo on how to write code for genetic algorithm as well as particle swarm optimization. In the morning presentation, I will say some theory and how the algorithm is how this algorithm is performing with respect to any objective function. But that's what we are going to see in the morning session. So what is genetic algorithm? So you need to understand by the term algorithm first. So what is an algorithm? It is a step-by-step procedure to solve any problem. So what for this algorithm is about? This algorithm is about to solve the problem of optimization. How this problem of optimization is stated? The problem of optimization is stated in a mathematical way with form maximum of f or minimum of f is equal to small f of x1 to xn. In such a way, the problem should be stated mathematically. If that way a problem is stated, then what is the duty of this algorithm? This algorithm has to do some certain stages to proceed with the solution to the problem. So who is the founder of this genetic algorithm? So it is John Holland in the year 1975. Which is the inspiration of this algorithm? Darwin's evolutionary theory is the inspiration for this algorithm. So before understanding what is evolutionary theory and why the name genetic is given to this algorithm, participants, please understand that it is an algorithm first. So what is an algorithm? It is a step-by-step process to solve any problem. So if a mathematical statement in terms of objective function is given to you, then the first step you need to do is representation of solution variable. Second step is random initialization of set of possible values for solution variable. Third step, evaluate each value of solution variable by calculating objective function. Fourth one, display the best value of objective function. Fifth one, creating the new set of possible value for solution variable by applying four major operations. Sixth step, just repeat the step of 3, 4, and 5 repeatedly until you expect the desired value for the given objective function. This is the step one has to follow for developing the algorithm that is called genetic algorithm. Participants, I will explain all the 6 steps programmatically in the afternoon session. So for right now, you just understand these are the steps that are required to solve any problem with respect to genetic algorithm. Why this algorithm is based on Darwin's evolutionary theory? See, in Darwin's evolutionary theory says that the survivability of any living creature is not the creation, but it's the desire to seek perfection. So originally, if you think that you look at this picture, in one part of stage, the bird mouth is something like this kind of size. Why this kind of size mouth birds are available at that time? The fruits are very bigger and it has to pick the fruit and it has to eat the fruit, or the seeds or other things are very bigger. But over the period of time, maybe due to some natural calamity or due to some natural changes or any other happenings in the creation, so they undergo some changes, and that changes will happen throughout the year or throughout the generation, and finally this kind of bird is appearing. So likewise, here also you can say that. So a man now in present form is stated that he has come from an animal called monkey. So what is the meaning here is the primary goal of any creature is to select mate with respect to each other individual to have many offspring as possible. So what is the theory mentioned by Darwin is the organism that are present in this present generation are evolved from some kind of previous n number of generation back. That is, previously only single cellular organisms are available when the world may be created. We are not in a position to explore further, but since that's why it is stated as theory. From that single cellular organism, multicellular organism came, then water living organisms might have come. From that water living organism, both water and land living organism may come. From that land living organism may come. Likewise, that evolution is happened. Why this evolution is happened? What make this evolution is to happen because of the genetical change. So we have some thing called a cell, and each cell is organized with respect to DNA, and each DNA is coded with the chromosome and the genes. So those are responsible for these kind of changes. See, the animal giraffe. At one point of time, these animals' neck is very large. Maybe 100 years of ago, 200 years of ago, if you look at giraffe, might be the giraffe's neck is very small. So what makes the giraffe leg to become very large? The theory of Darwin evolution state that one point of time, all the trees have been changed into very tall because of some natural calamities or some natural changes. The small sized trees may change to very big. So at that time, the animal which is having small neck, to seek its perfection, it's enlarging its neck to a little bit, to a little bit, to a little bit. Those animals which is getting food at that particular generation survive into the world. Those animals which are not getting food may go end up their life. So once the period of generation have been coming up, once part of a time, there might be some genes which is responsible for the portion of neck is getting some changes, some chemical changes. We may call the term by mutation. So due to such changes, so that neck may be enlarging. It is not happened in one day or it is not happened in 2 days. It happened over the period of generation or n number of years. That is the Darwin's evolutionary theory states that. So participants, I think you also know that the reason for not finding the medicine for the disease COVID is the virus that is responsible for this kind of disease is replicating themselves and modifying themselves. That is some kind of genetical changes. That is strictly speaking a kind of operation called mutation is happening in that virus. So that whenever you want to find a medicine, that medicine won't shoot for that virus. Because when the medicine is found out, the structure of the virus is changing constantly. So likewise, some constant change has been happened in the organism. So that we will get these kind of changes during the years to come. So that is the idea of evolutionary theory. This idea is used by John Haaland, and he started with some variables which is not the variable that we are expecting for the output of the objective function, but over the period of time that variable undergoes certain genetical operation. Say for example, see in the step 5, it is undergo some operations, and what point of time it will satisfy the objective function with the final value. So that is the idea proposed by algorithm creator John Haaland. Since this algorithm is more or less related with the Darwin's evolutionary theory, he has given the name genetic algorithm. So this slide will explain you why GA has its name. So genetically, we have a term called a gene. So if a mathematical function of form minimize or maxima f equal to small f of x1, x2, etc. up to that is given, then what are the variables? X1 and x2 are called? X1 and x2 are called solution variable. So it is mathematically called as a solution variable or simply variable, but genetically, that is biologically, it is called by the name gene. So collection of variables in the objective function. If n number of variables are available, then we may say that x1, x2, etc. up to xn, that those variables are called collectively by the name chromosome in genetically. So participants, here some notations are that 0, 0, 1, 0, 2, 5.4, A, all these things I will explain you in the afternoon practical session. You will understand that what is this called. This is called encoding. You will understand that. So So now my screen is visible. Yes, I guess now. Yes, yes, yes. So this slide, sorry for some network problem here, come in the middle. Sorry for the interruption. So this slide explains you the idea of why this algorithm is having the name genetic algorithm. Yes.
Sir, voice is not a. Sir, some echo is there.
Now it's okay?
No, sir.
Now it's not good, not okay?
Not okay, sir.
Hello? Okay?
Sir, some echo is there, sir. Still.
Hello. Hello. I think
okay.
You mute other participants also. Yes, all muted. Yes. Now you hear. Hello.
Sir, echo is there, sir.
Still. Is it audible now?
Sir, it's audible, sir, but echo is there, sir.
Oh, but I don't know whether the same position only I am sitting and telling, delivering the information. So I don't know. Hello.
Sir, if you are using headphones, sir.
Yeah, yes.
Sir, then you have to keep it.
Yeah, yes, yes. That's the way, that's the position for the past 5 days I am saying. Hello.
Sir, now it's okay.
Okay, no, now okay. May I proceed now? Yes.
Okay, sir.
Okay, so what I am trying to convey here is, even though you heard the term genetic algorithm, so it is not a biological based one, It is biologically inspired one, and it has many mathematical ideas associated with this. And this slide will clearly gives you the glimpse of idea why the GA has its name. That means why the term genetic is associated with this algorithm. Otherwise, we can simply say that it is an algorithm for solving a optimization problem. But why the term genetic is associated? Because the algorithm execution procedure and the algorithm methodology and the principle are more or less similar to the Darwin's evolutionary theory with the term gene, chromosome, population, selection, crossover, mutation. So hence it is treated like that. So strictly speaking, if you forgot about the term genetic, then we may say that so operation 1, operation 2, operation 3, operation 4 like that. If you look at the operation, say for example, let me look at the operation 3. What is the operation 3? It is the process of producing new value for the solution variable by swapping two already assigned value of the solution variable. So I will explain very detailedly in the afternoon practical session. So if you look at this operation 3, what is the thing happened is you have to take two value and you have to swap the two value, and this nothing but some kind of operation that is happened in the biological process, that is two genes are exchanging their values. So that's why it is given the name genetically as crossover. The same name can also be used for this operation, since the operation is similar to the operation that is happening in the biological scenario. So that's the way you can give this name of this algorithm as genetic algorithm. So GA and variance. So for example, if you look at it to literature, you can find many types of GA. Maybe if you are into research and if you collected many papers dealing with optimization, if you look into many papers dealing with the GA, you cannot see simply the word GA. If you look into the paper, you can have many varieties of GA. So let me explain how the variety have come, or how these different flavors of GA have come. So in general, a GA start with the problem by accepting the objective function. First, it will do the problem representation. So based on the problem representation, it will initialize the population. Then it has to evaluate the objective function. After evaluating the objective function, then it will check whether if we reach the goal or not. So once it reaches the goal, it will either go to stop the process, or it will go end with the it will go to the operation. Whether suppose if it the objective function is not satisfied. So what are the operations? I said operation 1, operation 2, operation 3, operation 4. That is elitism, selection, crossover, and mutation. These four operations has been conducted. So that is the way the genetic algorithm is executing for a simple process. So if you want to have different version of GA, there occurs the problem with problem representation. If you choose binary information, that is 1s and 0, then it is binary GA. If you use integer value for the variables x1, x2, x3, then it is real integer GA. Or if it is real values for real GA, then if it is mixed number, both the binary and the real, or binary and integer, if that is followed, then it is mixed GA. So what is the case of genetic operation? If you use simple genetic operation, simple crossover, simple mutation, simple selection operation, then it is simple GA. There are literature which discuss many advanced operation. So and that way you can say with the name of improved GA or enhanced GA, or you can go with the hybridizing of GA with some other algorithms. So in that case, you can have the name as hybrid GA. So this is the way in which you can look into the various genetic operations. For selection operations available are Rowlett field, or tournament selection, for crossover, some popular crossovers I have listed down, and for mutations, some popular mutation operations are listed out. So it is not meant that you need to go only with this kind of operation. There are some other operations are available. So this is just a plug and play way for which you need to get a good results. So one can go for using Rowlett-Weed selection for selection task, two-point crossover for a crossover task, and bitwise mutation for mutation tasks. Or someone may go for tournament selection, arithmetic crossover, or non-uniform mutation. Or someone we go with Rowlett's field selection, BLX alpha, or uniform mutation. So likewise, you have to go with a different kind of operation. So what you need to do is you need to apply four operations: selection operation, crossover operation, mutation operation, and elitism operation. For selection, you can go with any one of the selection operation. Likewise, for crossover, any one of the crossover. For mutation, any one of the mutation. For elitism, there is only one, that is keeping the best individual separated. That is the operation in elitism. So no subdivision operations are available in elitism. So these are all the kinds of operation that you can do. And if any combination of operation you have chosen, accordingly the GA will vary. So this is the way in which you can have different varieties of GA. So let me go into the next algorithm, particle swarm optimization algorithm. So what is the principle behind genetic algorithm is evolutionary theory. Based on the evolutionary theory, you have only three algorithms: genetic algorithm, evolutionary strategy, and evolutionary programming. So in that algorithm, what is missing is some kind of memory is missing. When compared with shallow neural network with deep recurrent neural network, what is missing? Memory is missing because of the feedback connection. So similar to that, here, when you compare with the GA and the PSO, what is missing is PSO has some inherent memory in it, whereas GA doesn't have. With the help of that memory, PSO is faster when compared with the GA. So as well as PSO is meant only for powerful for real coded values, not for other kind of values. Even though you code PSO with other values, binary or any other representation, but PSO is very powerful in terms of real values. So what is the basic difference between GA and PSO? GA is an algorithm which does optimization without inherent memory in it. PSO is an algorithm which has some inherent memory in it. That's why PSO and artificial B colony algorithm and Ant colony algorithm, they are all treated as one category, that is called swarm intelligence. So participant, you please remember, evolutionary computation is a set of algorithm which has its own principle, that is based on the evolutionary theory. Swarm intelligence is a kind of algorithm, it has its own principle, that is based on group of social behavior of group of animals or group of insects or group of birds. So it has its own principle, but the basic difference is there no memory is there. Here some kind of memory is there to understand the previous values of any parameters associated with the algorithm. So this algorithm is meant to solve a problem, that is to for conducting the optimization. And this algorithm has been developed by two scientists, Russell Eberhardt and James Kennedy, in the year 1995. In order to find limitation with the genetic algorithm, they found out two equations. They introduced two parameters. One is velocity parameter, another one is position parameter. So based on that two parameter introduced by the two scientists, they have used some kind of inspiration from the nature. So let me explain this. Before that, what is the velocity value? That is, new velocity value is equal to old velocity value plus some component. That component is called as individual intelligence, plus some component. That component is called as group intelligence. So that old velocity value is multiplied by a weight value. So every time these things are updated so that the final value for the objective function is received. So this is the inspiration for BSO, that is birds searching for food and their social interaction. That is generally food searching behavior of the bird. During the food searching behavior, how much social interaction the bird is having with themselves. So those behaviors are studied by those scientists. Here in the natural scenario, you will assume a bird, but here in the algorithm, it is treated as a particle. So this particle is having two parameters. One is position, another one is velocity. So these two parameters are used during the course of the algorithm execution process, and that parameter will make us to find the optimal value for the objective function given. So here you may find out one way value, that is food. That food is nothing but the final solution. Imagine a group of birds are flying, and each bird is objective is to find the food source, which is having maximum amount of food. So each bird is communicating with one another. There some foot position is available with in a better way. Here some foot position is available in a better way. So individually, the bird is searching the food to locate the good food source position. On the whole, the birds are finding the good food source position. So that is treated by the variable P best and G best. B best is nothing but individual's best food value, and G best is the individual's overall food best value. This parameter that I will explain in the afternoon session during the practical demo with the respect to the MATLAB code. So what is social interaction behavior of food? So I told that, so this is the formula for updating the new velocity, that is old velocity with respect to weight. This component C1 rand 1 of PID minus XID, this component, and this component C2 rand 2 of PD. So this first component is treated as the social interaction, or it is cognitive behavior, whereas the second component is decided as the social behavior, that is individual behavior as well as social behavior. The first component is individual behavior. The second component is social behavior. Let me explain what is individual cognitive behavior, that is individual's behavior. Remember, some set of birds are flying. So those birds are flying for searching their food. Remember, in a group of bird, one bird find a food source position where some 100 amount of food is available. One bird find a food position where some 80 amount of food position is available. One bird is finding a food position where some 50 amount of food is available. Now, there is a communication among these birds. So while this communication is happening, the bird which is finding lowest food position available will go to the bird which is finding the maximum food position. So individually, this bird is having some intelligence, finding the position which is of 100 amount of food. This bird is finding the 80 amount of food, and this bird is finding food 50 amount of food. But collectively, some kind of social interaction is there among the birds, so that each bird will understand the food assumed by its own with respect to other bird and move to the bird which is having maximum food. So this natural scenario is have been mathematically stated as the second component in the velocity function. Now come to the social behavior. In the social behavior, see, for example, look at this one. Bird 1 is finding the position of food 150, bird 2 100, bird 300, and bird 4 400. Now one bird is there, it has a confusion towards which bird I have to fly, whether I have to fly towards the bird 1 or bird 2 or bird 3. So here comes the social interaction. It will interact with all the other birds and will come to know that only the bird 4 is having maximum food. Accordingly, it will go to the bird 4th direction, where the bird 4 is going in one direction, that direction this bird will move. So that is the social behavior of the food. So individually, each bird is having its own behavior in finding the food. Collectively, it is having its own behavior for finding the food. But all are meant to get some good amount of food so that its daily way need of getting food is satisfied. So this behavior in the natural scenario is studied by these two scientists, and they have given find out an algorithm by remembering or by having small intelligence into the process of optimization. And we have given with the flowchart when against the GA. What this flowchart says about us? So you have to start the problem. Before start the problem, you need to have the mathematical function. So from the mathematical function, how to understand what are the variables, that is the decision variables available. Based on the decision variable, you have to initialize the position as well as velocity of the particle in a random manner. And for each position and velocity, you have to evaluate the fitness, that is objective function. The objective function is given, that has to be evaluated. Once the objective function is evaluated, then the objective function is checked, whether it is its own individual best or whether it crosses the global best or not. So something is there inside the loop, so that it comes out of the loop after getting updated the individual best value as well as the social best value. Then finally, in the outer loop, it will final update the overall value of the velocity as well as the position to gives out the final G best value, which is treated as the best solution. I will explain this process in the MATLAB code. I hope you will understand the idea better in the MATLAB code when I show the each block's code individually, and individually if I execute to give you the output. So with this, I will close the PSO part. Let me go into another part. So artificial B colony algorithm. It is also an algorithm for solving an optimization problem. So where its biological inspiration have come from? Its biological inspiration comes from the way in which it is searching for the honey. So assume the honey hive. So there you can find n number of honey bees. How the honey is collected by the bee and how it is segregated into the honey hive. So that studied by these scientists, Dervis Karboga, and he invented this algorithm for solving the optimization problem. So let me explain the biological scenario first, then I will go to the algorithm part. So what is the biological scenario? To understand the biological scenario of the artificial bee colony, you have to assume or you have to imagine there are three kinds of bees in the hive. One is employed bee, unemployed bee. So in the category of unemployed bee, you have scout bee and onlooker bee. So there are three kinds of bee: employed bee, scout bee, and onlooker bee. What is the duty of employed bee? It will always go out of the hive and searches for the food. So every time when it searches for the food, like the particle swarm optimization algorithm, it will always have knowledge about the food source position. This position we have many food. This position we have only less amount of food. Like that, it always keep track of the food source position. Once the employed bee searches the food, it comes back to the hive and give information to other bees. Then it is the duty of the onlooker bee to go to the bee's location, that is where the employed bees have gone. There it goes directly, instead of searching directly, it goes to the place where employed bees have gone, and then it will take the food or take the honey from the flower or from the place where it is going to collect. So randomly some kind of bee has been come out from the hive. It is called a scout bee. So it will find the new food source position, so that it will also be used for the bee to get understandable for the objective function to get satisfied. So let me explain in an animatical way. Imagine there are four food source position. So food source position blue in terms of blue flower, food source position pink in terms of pink flower, food source position yellow in terms of yellow flower, and orange flower. So imagine a hive in the center. So two bees, that is first of all employed bee, this one is a scout bee. So scout bee is always sitting in the hive. Whenever it needs, it goes out, find the flower and suck the honey and come to the hive. But it is the duty of the employed bee always go to the food source position and searching for the hive. So now I will explain this in a two employed bees are there. It go to some kind of flowers randomly, find the honey inside the flower, suck the honey inside the flower. So it is sucking the honey inside the flower, then comes out of the flower and comes to the hive. Otherwise, it goes to the neighboring flower, it will suck the honey and it will come to the hive. So it is the duty of the scout bee, whenever it thinks out, it goes to flower and it will suck the honey in it. So after the employed bee goes around the garden or goes around the place where honeys are available, where flowers and honeys are available, take down the honey and comes to the hive. There in the hive, it has a set of bees called onlooker bee. The onlooker bee always waiting for the employed bee whether it gets any information or not. So there in the hive, some kind of dancing movement is happened. So some kind of dancing movement is happened. This dancing movement is nothing but some kind of communication among the bee. So the employed bee communicates with the onlooker bee. What kind of communication it is communicating? So I found a flower, there more honeys are there. You have to go in that direction. So you have to go in that much distance. So that if you go that much distance, if you go in that direction, you will find a flower. There you will find a more number of honeys. Then you can get those honeys and come back to the hive. So those kind of information is communicated in the dance. So in that dance will communicate two information, the direction as well as the distance. By accepting the direction as well as the distance, the onlooker bee will go to the flower. See? The three onlooker bee come to one flower and one. So that means these three onlooker bee have received well the information from the employed bee. So it getting into the hive, suck the honey and then come back to the flower. So this is the way the natural scenario is working out. So that natural scenario is converted into an algorithm for solving the optimization problem. To understand the algorithm process, I have given only the flow chart. So to understand the process, let me explain the flow chart a while. You need to understand the algorithm in three phases. That is employed phase, onlooker phase, and scout phase. So this first entire set of block is employed phase. Here, what has happened is some random generation of food source position is generated, and its position value is used for evaluating the fitness value. Then with the help of some greedy approach, the position values are updated. Then the updated position value is submitted to the onlooker bees. There also food source position is taken. It is utilized to find the updation of food source position. Then it is used for evaluating the fitness value. Then the new food source position is created with the help of greedy selection. Some kind of scout bee is there, right? So those scout bees randomly replace the food source position with new food source position with the help of scout bee. So this process is repeatedly conducted under three stages: employed bee phase, scout bee phase, and onlooker phase. At one point of time, what you will infer is you will get a saturation point. At that saturation point will give you the best value. Otherwise, the same process has to be repeated again and again. So I have given only the glimpse of idea about this ABC. More concept is there. So I will go to new part of this particular today's presentation, ant colony optimization. So what is ant colony optimization? So ant colony optimization, as the name implies, it inspired the natural behavior of how ant is searching for the food. I think you notice in your home, whenever some food particle is there in your home, that food particle has been easily tracked by the ant, and that food particle is having some line of ants are available towards that food particle. At one point of time, you'll notice that some line of ants are available towards the food particle. So that is the idea inspired by the scientist Margot Dorico to understand the process of ant colony optimization. So this kind of ant colony optimization is widely applied for a problem consisting of combinations. So those problems are popularly called by the name combinatorial optimization. What are the problems that are treated as combinatorial optimization? Traveling salesman problem, minimum spanning tree, ATQ's problem, scheduling problem, NASHAQ problem. So what is it means? If a problem that involves combination of variable, that is 1, 2, 3, 4, like that, if it involves only combination of variable, then that where problem is treated as combinatorial optimization problem. So if you face any kind of combinatorial optimization problem, then you can use this ant colony optimization problem for finding the solution. Participants, if you are from computer science background, you know well that spanning tree problem. So spanning tree problem in data structure concepts, we studied some algorithm. Those algorithms are treated as conventional algorithms by means of which the problem solution has been found out. Likewise, NAPSAC problem also you can, ATQIN's problem also, backtracking method. So you can find the solution to that problem. But those solutions are meant for some benchmark problem only. If you have some real world problem involving many number of variables and many number of complex form of objective function, then those algorithms won't be a support to solve the such kind of problem. Then you will need to go for some powerful algorithm like this kind of algorithm to find solution to the problem. So that is the ant colony optimization. So once again, I am saying that. So if you put any food particle in a place, the ant will go towards the place finding the food source. So in what way it will going? So once it starts from one point to another point to reach the food particle, so it will follow the paths randomly. At one point of time, all the random paths will be formed into a straight line. So this is the way the ants will behave in nature for searching their food. So this behavior is studied by this scientist, and he has given an algorithm in the form of ant colony optimization. So to start this ant colony optimization algorithm, so you have been provided with objective function. So you have to initialize the parameter. What are the parameters here is the parameter is pheromone. So the pheromone is also a chemical name given with the ants behavior while walking in, while passing to get the food. Some kind of chemical substance is deposited by the ant while going towards the food particle. So those name is given here also. So pheromone, so for the value is nothing but some value between 0 and 1, it is initialized. Then its probability value is calculated. Then its ranges are calculated. Those ranges are nothing but path. Once that is set to done, what is the, you have to do is you have to randomly generate n number of ants. Each ant with respect to the probability value is utilized to calculate the objective function. If the objective function value calculated is set to match with the expected value, if it is matching with the matching with the expected value, then it means that you have to stop the algorithm process. Otherwise, you go for updation. So this is the way the ant colony algorithm is utilized. Participant, please understand the principle behind this. All the Bayer-Inspired algorithms, you start randomly, you evaluate the objective function, and you check whether the objective function goal is reached or not. If not, then the randomly initialized value is updated. So random initialization, evaluation, cross verification whether it reaches or not, then modification. So initialization, evaluation, checking the convergence criteria, otherwise modification. The modification is conducted with the help of operation. With respect to genetic algorithm, how many operations? 4 operations. With respect to PSO, 2 operations. With respect to ABC, 3 stages. And each stage, we have n number of operations. And here in ant colony, you have one operation, that is pheromone updation operation. That too, we have local pheromone as well as global pheromone operation. So that's the general principle of particles by various Bayer-Inspired optimization algorithm. And with respect to ASEO, that is ant colony optimization, you need to go for these kind of steps for implementing the algorithm. So the ABC algorithm and the ACO algorithm is just to understand the idea. In the afternoon lab class, I will teach you the practical code for that two algorithms. If you are really interested in developing the code for the rest of the algorithms, I may please be contacted. So I will explain you in depth about this algorithm. Due to time constraint, I will limit only the general idea. So what participant, what I have given to you is only the general idea about the 4 algorithms. So there are much more in that idea. So to explain genetic algorithm, I need complete one day to you. Likewise for all the algorithms, one day is required. With this time, what I have delivered to you is just an idea. So with this idea, if you refer any articles, then you can, I assure you that you can confidently understand the process. If not, I may be contacted. I will be helping you to do some kind of stuff with respect to your problem. So let me go into the other kind of algorithms with respect to Bayer-Inspired algorithms. Water cycle algorithm based on the water behavior, raindrop optimization, intelligent water drop optimization. One of my scholar have used this algorithm, intelligent water drop, and one of my scholar have used this algorithm, water cycle algorithm, firefly algorithm, fish swam algorithm, shuffled frog leap algorithm, invasive weed colony optimization, biography, harmony. So there are bacterial foraging, bat algorithm, cat swarm algorithm. So likewise, you can find n number of algorithms are available, and each algorithm duty is to understand 3 behavior. One is mating behavior. One is mating behavior. Second one is foraging behavior. And the third one is nesting behavior. What is mating behavior? Finding the peers, do some kind of reproduction process and comes up with a good individual. What is the second process? Food foraging process. So that is searching for the food. In what way the animals are having some kind of intelligence to search for the food. Those behavior are studied. What is the third behavior? Nesting behavior. In what way the bird or animal is constructing the nest for its living. Those behavior are studied. So the natural scientist studied 3 nesting behavior, mating behavior, and food foraging behavior. These 3 behavior have been studied. And for each behavior, mathematically operation have been defined, and that mathematical operation is used in the optimization problem statement for finding the objective function value. So that is the overall principle began the bio-inspired optimization algorithm. And if you look at literature, you can find enormous number of algorithms. See, swarm intelligence-based algorithms, bio-inspired algorithms, physics and chemistry-based algorithms, and other stuff algorithms. So you can find n number of things. It is countably, if you find any animal, if you put any animal based on the algorithm, you can find. So likewise, n number of algorithms are available in the literature, and it is up to you to choose or desire one particular algorithm based on the nature of your problem and comes out with a good solution. So I will give one video here. Let me explain how a nature problem is studied and how that studied process has been utilized for developing the algorithm. So what this video is about? See, this is a picture of slime mold. What is slime mold? It is a fungus, right? So how the fungus is formed? The fungus is formed at one point. If you find the fungus, then you can remove the fungus at that day itself. If you allow the fungus to grow, maybe days of time, 1 week of time, 1 month of time, if you allow the fungus to grow, it will grow over the food particle. At one time of time, it will completely collapse the food particle. Remember, fungus is a unicellular organism, and it also has its own intelligence. So some of the scientists have studied this slime mold, that is a fungus, in what way it is expanding its branch, what intelligence it is having, whether that intelligence can be converted into a mathematical operation so that the mathematical operation can be effectively used for solving optimization problem. Still, that task is under research. So participants, I will run this video to understand the biological intelligence that this fungus is having for searching the food, or in what way it is expanding its branches for searching its food. If you're thorough with that operation, and if you are in a position, it is an open challenge to you to design an algorithm based on this process. Then you may give one optimization to the scientific community or the research community, that is slime mold optimization algorithm like that. So that way you can go for using the idea of bio-inspired algorithm. So let me share this screen to you. See, in this scene of this video, a food particle is placed here and a fungus is placed here. So the fungus is traveling from this place to this point to capture the food. So the scientists later, they observed that the path that is chosen by this slime mold to reach the food particle is very short. That means it is having some kind of intelligence. So even though it is has many paths, see, it can go here, it can go here, it can go here, it can go here. So even though it is provided with n number of options to reach the food, it is taking only the shortest path. Means that it has some kind of intelligence in it. Likewise only, Darwin's evolutionary theory have been successfully studied by the John Halland, and based on that, he developed a genetic algorithm. So Eberhardt and Russell have studied the food foraging behavior of the bird and developed the PSO. Davis Harbora have studied the way in which honey bee is working. He invented the artificial bee colony algorithm. And Morgo Dorigo have studied the ants behavior and developed the ants bee colony algorithm. So it is a challenge to you. If you are interested, you can study this behavior further and you can develop a slime mold optimization algorithm. So what here they are doing is, in the research lab at Tokyo University, they are creating a slide in which each dot here represents a food particle. That food particle is nothing but represents a airport. And here you have placed the slime mold. And they have made the video to run. So after that, what they observed is the slime mold expand its network and find the food particle, and the path established by the slime mold is the very shortest path. So in such way, the slime mold have its own intelligence and is finding the shortest path. Later, they observed this kind of network formed by the slime mold, and they matched with the existing airport network of the Tokyo city. There they found that new kind of routes have been possible. See, new kinds. This route is not already there in their predefined routes. So what they have inferred from that intelligence is they have created a new route so that the effective routes are utilized, and fuel consumption by the airport line has been effectively utilized. So in such a way, the research has to be conducted. So let me come back to our presentation. So how these much algorithms have been developed by every scientist by observing the algorithm, you can develop the algorithm on your own by observing the behavior also. We have developed one algorithm when I was in South Korea as a postdoctoral fellow. We observed the swirling behavior of the water. So whenever you pour water in the kitchen sink, or you can find that the water doesn't flow in a single direction, there kind of some swirling motion is there in the sink of water. You can observe whenever you notice or whenever you clean the sink, or you can observe the same behavior in any kind of dam also, or in any cyclone comes also, you can observe that behavior. The water have some kind of swirl motion in it. So the swirl motion, how it is created and what is the motivating science behind the swirling motion of the water. So we studied that behavior and we applied a patent and we developed an optimization algorithm out of that behavior of swirling motion of water. And we applied that developed optimization algorithm into cancer disease prediction process, in which a fuzzy classifier model have been developed, and that fuzzy classifier model have been hybridized with the newly created algorithm based on water swirling motion, and some kind of better results which has been used by that hospital, Kwangpuk National University Hospital, have been developed, and that same can be patented with the host professor then by were working as a postdoc in South Korea during the year 15 and 16. So this is one challenge to you so that you can study further with the help of this idea to develop an algorithm on your own. So these are all some references. You can study these kind of stuff further with the help of this reference. And now it is the session for question. So if you have any question, you can ask. Participants, here I have given a overall idea about various optimization algorithms. Roughly 4 optimization algorithms we have discussed. In the afternoon session, I will give you the code, how to develop GA as well as PSO for any objective function. So now I open the session for question. Yes. Yes, ma'am. Manjula, you can ask the question now.
Sir, good morning, sir. Sir, yes, in PSO, position and velocity, these two are used as a parameters. Sir, these parameters can be used to identify the moving object. That is, maybe in the vehicle, or there also we can have a position and velocity. Yes. And a human being, and that they is. Are maybe walking. So we can find out the position of the human being with the help of PSO. Can we use it for that, sir?
No, ma'am. See that what is what is the position and velocity in this algorithm is. I wish to come to this slide. I will come to this slide to explain you further. If you look at this, why GA has its name? See, this is the biological name, right? Gene is the biological name. But actually, what is gene in mathematically? It is solution variable. Yes, likewise, sir. In PSO, velocity means it is not the actual velocity that what you are trying to convey. It is a number between 0 to 1. That's it. Okay. And what is position is, it is the value for the variable x1 and x2. So you are thinking about the natural velocity and the position.
Yes, sir.
So what is in the algorithm is, even though the term velocity and the position is used, it is nothing but set of solution variable and that's associated value. That's it. Not actual velocity and the position. I think it will be clear to you when I explain the demo code. What is velocity? Velocity is a parameter. So you do not think that this velocity is equal to the velocity in the natural scenario.
Scientists have
studied the natural scenario, and that natural scenario velocity, how far it is useful, that usefulness has been taken here.
Okay.
So when a person is walking, he may have some speed, right?
Yes, sir.
If he is running, he may have some speed. So yes. Running means he is very faster to reach the target. Walking means he is slower to reach the target. So what is there between these two person who is walking and who is running? The velocity as well, that is the speed of the two person is varying. So some kind of variable is there so that the objective function has to be satisfied very earlier. So that is the idea inspired by the scientists, and they have used the idea there. So since it is treated inspired idea from the natural process, they have used the name. Actually, velocity is not the one. In the algorithm that is treated with natural one.
Okay.
So I think it is clear to you when I explain in the practical demo class.
Yes, sir.
It is just a number, ma'am. It is not, you do not confuse with the natural process.
Okay, sir. Sir, and one more thing, sir. In ABC, yes. We have the scout B, which is located in the same place. It doesn't come to the hive, sir.
Come, ma'am. Yeah. See, I am not an animation creator. I am not an animation creator. It will come. It will come to the hive. So just to understand the idea, I have given these glimpse of thoughts, but it will come. It will come. Without coming, we cannot evaluate the objective function, right?
Okay, sir. Thank you, sir.
So
Thank you.
if you deep into the research, see, we are working these 4 algorithms and more than these 4 algorithms we have worked so far for the past 10 to 15 years. If you look at the operation of the scout B, then you may say that the scout B operation is equivalent to mutation operation in genetic algorithm.
Hmm.
So that's the idea here.
Okay. Thank you, sir. Very nice presentation, sir. I can understand well, sir.
Okay, ma'am. But what is the thing that I have given here is just an idea.
Yes.
Like deep neural networks and expert system as the theme of this seminar, So Bayer inspired algorithms can be taught to you as another 5 days program like this, because with 1 hour I cannot give you in depth about every algorithm, because every algorithm is a very big one. So what I have given in this session is just an idea. What is GA? What is PSO? What is ABC and what is ACO? What is its specialties? In what way you can use it? What are their similarities and differences? And how to make one to think about any such kind of nature inspired algorithm with respect to slime mold? Like that only I have given the idea to you.
Thank you, sir. Thank you very much, sir.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you, ma'am. Thank you. So is there any other question? The participants, do you have any question? If you have question, you can raise. Otherwise, we will close the session. See, remember, participant, these two algorithms, this bio-inspired optimization algorithm can be easily joined with a neural network as well as a fuzzy expert system. So if you want to develop an optimal pattern recognition system or an optimal fuzzy expert system, then this approach is very essential. Is there anyone want a question? So if you don't have any question, I think I can stop the presentation. So thanks.
Yes, sir. No one raised the question, sir.
Yes, yes, yes. We can stop the session, right?
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Yes, sir, we will start the session, afternoon session at 10.
Yeah, we will start the afternoon session by 3 o'clock.
Okay, sir.
Okay. So 3 o'clock we will meet again, right?
We will plan accordingly.
Okay. 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 Thank you. Thank you so much.
Okay.
Thank
sir.
You, Anurag. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you.